The ability to retain impressions of sensory information after the original stimuli have ended. Iconic memory is a momentary sensory memory of visual stimuli, a photographic or picture image memory lasting no more than a few tenths of a second. Echoic memory, a momentary sensory memory of auditory stimuli. If attention is elsewhere, sounds and words can still be recalled within 3 or 4 seconds. What are the duration and capacity of short-term and long-term memory? At any time, we can focus and process about 7 items of information, new or retrieved. Without rehearsal, information disappears from short-term memory within seconds. While our capacity for storing information permanently in long-term memory is essentially unlimited. How does the brain store our memories? Through synaptic changes, stress hormones, and memory. Flashbulb memories are a clear memory of an emotionally significant moment or event. Amnesia is the loss of memory. We are more likely to remember vivid events that form flashbulb memories. We have 2 memory systems, explicit and implicit memories. Explicit memories are of general knowledge, facts, and experiences, and are processed by the hippocampus. Implicit memories are of skills and conditioned responses, and are processed by other parts of the brain, including the cerebellum. The hippocampus is a temporal lobe neural center that forms part of the brain's limbic system and helps process explicit memories and feed them to other brain regions for storage. The cerebellum is the brain region extending out from the rear of the brainstem that plays a key role in forming and storing implicit memories created by classical conditioning. If damaged, you will be unable to develop certain conditioned reflexes, such as leaving the classroom when the bell rings. Long-term potentiation, or LTP, is an increase in a synapse's firing potential after brief, rapid stimulation. It's believed to be a neural basis for learning and memory.